your hormones?
Correct.
Because you brought up the comfort zone. What exactly do we have them? What are they?
Yes.
And how do we control them?
Correct.
As part of this?
So, you know, we're getting hungry, right? It's been a long day for you. It's been a long day for me.
Well, I did expect you to bring in lunch, but that's okay.
So we both get hungry, and that doesn't happen by accident. You're getting hungry because of a hormonal influence. Everything we do really comes from a sort of hormonal influence. So there's a hormone called ghrelin. There's a singular hunger hormone. And there's one hormone that makes you hungry. And you'll see the other side of that graphic, which is leptin. Leptin is one of the hormones that helps you feel full. So there's interaction. There's actually multiple hormones, or what are called satiety hormones, that satiety come from satisfied, comes from making you feel full, that go to counteract the effect of ghrelin. So ghrelin is the singular hunger hormone that comes from your stomach. Leptin in particular is more along a long-term energy balance that sends the signal to your brain of this is how much adipose tissue is around, this is how much energy there is on reserve, if you will. And the brain interprets that. There are very core central places of the brain where these hormones begin to affect. Leptin crosses the blood-brain barrier, and it particularly influences what's called the hypothalamic centers, which are, again, really core parts of your brain that begin to turn off, in the case of leptin, the effects of ghrelin. So it's kind of like driving, for those of you that remember, a stick shift car. You know, you either hit the accelerator or you hit the clutch, right? You have to sort of work, and you can't be hungry and full at the same time. So these hormones work against each other. And understanding that there may be patients that have leptin resistance, meaning that the leptin isn't really telling the brain when the patient is satisfied and full, that may lead to obesity. That may lead to a chronic history of excessive eating and excessive calorie intake. So those hormones need to be evaluated. Those hormones need to be assessed as to whether they're in play. And there's a specific, speaking about genetics, there's a specific genetic disorder, which is not common, very, very small amount of people who have a leptin receptor deficiency. And those are not the common. That's a very outlying, what's called a monogenetic cause for obesity. Those are typically seen in children.